We have a good rally underway here. Market internal show we've got far more buyers out there than sellers. We begin with Europe's biggest market, the FTSE in London right now, up 54 points, that's 1%. In Paris, the CAC 40, up 50, 1.2%. In Frankfurt, the DAX is up 29 on the floor and up 53 in the broader Xetra index.
It looks like people have come back from the long holiday weekend in a buying mood. Technology stocks among them surging on Instanet. Stocks like Dell Computer, which is split today. It is trading at about $58 a share after a split. That's up 3 5/16. Applied Materials also higher by 1 3/16. Microsoft also trading up, as is all of the internet stocks. Yahoo right now up 4.25 points on Instanet. Amazon.com up 1 3/4. And Apple Computer also higher by 1 3/16. So look for those technology stocks to really lead the activity this morning. Biotech stocks as well trading up on Instanet. There is a call coming out of Goldman Sachs today. A lot of people, by the way, have been talking about biotech
Wake
stocks
up. Saying that this is a what do you think? Asian market has been closed for 2 hours. London has been trading for over an hour, and you don't know squat.
I get the journal.
Yeah, the journal's cute. Aside from a couple of feature stories, remember, today's paper is yesterday's news. Okay, today, you get to watch the master and be part of something bigger than life. Buy S&P futures.
Are you sure?
Never mind. You just buy 10,000 contracts. You got that?
What about Kathleen?
Who?
Director of training.
Oh, please. Did she just give you little pricks of speech on principles? Remember, in this business, when a person reminds you of their principles, they always have their interest in mind.
Now get your ass in gear.
I just got up.
What the hell have you been doing? Taking notes? Move it.
And pipeline gaining visibility in 1999.
Damn NBAs. Think they're special. Welcome to the jungle.
Tomato Nicole to put away a nail polish and get me everything on a Chicago-based company called TechCom. TechCom. Everything. Yeah, I want to know due diligence report, I want the historical trades and the Vickers report on my desk when I get up there. Yes. Okay. I want to know when the VP's taking crap after lunch. All right. I'll talk to you soon. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Mike.
Hey, what's doing, Jay? All right. I'll talk to you.
What
Nothing
are you
much.
Doing?
Nothing much, man. I'm on the phone. I'll be up there in a little while.
All right. I'll wait for you.
No. Jay, I'll meet you up there, right? I'm a little busy. I'll be about 5 more minutes,
you
right?
Sure?
Yeah, I swear to God. Yeah, go up there.
All right. See you later.
I'll talk to you soon. Yeah. Okay. Yes, all right. I'll talk to you about after lunch. All right. Bye-bye. Yeah. All right. You got that?
It's an Italian place on around 52nd Street. I don't know, 6th, 7th Broadway.
So what do you think?
Sounds like a hunk of crap.
Tony, what's your opinion of the new fund percentage leverage guidelines?
Does anybody know the name of the restaurant that Ronald Buckman took us to last month?
They can't all of a sudden dictate fund positions. Why the hell are we managers if they're doing all the managing?
They're the bosses.
Who's the bosses? We're the bosses. Don't you guys have your own office to go to?
Can't you guys just enter in restaurants and Star 5 and all the restaurants in the 50s will pop up?
We're waiting for your scoop from the floor.
Yeah, what's the atmosphere like down there?
What's this? Money managers concerned with traders? What are you guys trying to turn over a quick profit?
For shame, guys. For shame. Tony, I got work to do. I need a phone.
Hold on. Give me a sec. Please, hold on.
Yeah.
Diane's on hold, and Larry from TechCom just called on line two.
Tell Diane I'll call her back. Larry! Yeah, what's up?
They say that there are so many tech IPOs with no earnings that some guidance is justified. Most don't even have any earnings at all. And the people are buying them on future expected earnings.
Yeah.
Management season is a very volatile situation.
I'm doing what I gotta do.
How long have you been here?
What? We're going.
This happens every year and it lasts for about 3 months.
I got options up my gazoo.
Why should that concern me? I manage an S&P index fund. Michael's the one with all the tech stocks.
It was too difficult to determine where to draw the line. They're all tangible.
Yeah.
If you use enough absurdity, the whole market is cyclical.
That's a crock.
Hey, guys, I'm on the phone.
Mike, please, the operator's still on hold.
Okay, Larry, yeah. Uh-huh, all right. I'll call you later.
James, glad you made it.
What's up, buddy?
I want you to meet Michael Casarino, master of the game, 3 years running, with an average fund growth of 37%.
Well, everyone tells me I should meet you.
Who's this?
James is the new manager of the Herculean Fund.
Really? Wow, the company's a big boy, huh? So what fund did you manage before this?
None. This is my first.
He was recruited right out of Wharton's MBA program. He has a master's in economics as well as one in global finance. Valedictorian, national president of the business society of his fraternity. His thesis has received 5 Ivy League citations and is now used as a training guide for global investing. He was also...
But thanks for the inflated bio. Jay put it a little better than it is.
Sounds like the same old BS to me. I see your types come and go. Remember one thing, in the real world, in the jungle, things work a little differently. I realize in your little controlled school environment, everything falls into place nice and neat. But here, instincts is what gives high grades, and the ability to handle pressure is what...
Cut it out. Stop being a jerk. Does anybody remember the name of the restaurant we went to last month?
Martini's.
Thank you.
And I owe you one.
Hey, you're not thinking of taking a position with them, are you? Company's way too immature. Now, I see too many inconsistencies between stock, production, and inventory. Too many unanswered questions. I'd wait a little while if I were you.
Yeah, and wait for the company to go sixfold? I don't think so.
Don't let that define who he is. He's really a good guy.
May I?
Mr. Donovan, of course.
Oh, please, call me Kevin. I'm sorry about your office not being ready. Hope you don't mind the inconvenience.
Not at all. I can work anywhere.
You know, news travels quickly around an office. I hear you met Michael. Now, don't judge him too quickly. He has great instincts, and he's been a wonderful asset to this office. I know he can have an inflated ego, but he means well.
No problem. I just felt more like his prey rather than his colleague.
That's an interesting observation. You know, before he started working here, his nickname was the Wolf Man. You know, I read your thesis on global investment and the cyclical effect of emerging countries on the larger GNP. Very, very insightful.
Well, thank you.
Which brings me to the reason for being here. We're starting a new hedge fund, and we'd like for you to manage it. Oh, hi, Kat.
Hi. I have that Wessler account, and I just need your approval.
Excuse me just a minute. I'll be back in the office in just a few minutes.
Okay. Thank you.
Mr. Donovan, I appreciate your confidence in me, but I have to tell you honestly that I don't think I'm the right person for the job. First of all, I've already got the Herculean Fund. It's the company's largest. All my time is devoted to that. Besides, you know how I feel about hedge funds. They're too risky, too volatile. I think Michael might be the better candidate for the job. In fact, I think he might jump at the offer.
See, that's just it. You know, I feel that Michael may be consumed with too much passion.